Hi, I'm Melissa.
I'm Sarah.
We're from KidLiterate.com, and we are here today to tell you about one of our all-time favorite children's book authors and illustrators, someone who we kind of feel like we discovered, even though we know that that's not true.
Clearly.
We do know that we sold...
He has an agent.
Yes. But we do know that we sold more copies of his one of his books probably than any other store in the country, unless there's an independent down the street from his house. His name is Chris Van Dusen, and the book that we're talking about that we love so much is called If I Built a Car. It is the most perfect five-year-old boy book of all time.
It's true.
Yeah.
It's
it
true.
Really is. And if for some reason you have never seen it, you are missing out. But we're not going to talk about that book today. We're going to talk about a couple of Chris's other books. If I Built a Car, by the way, is a Penguin book. But we also love Down to the Sea with Mr. McGee and A Camping Spree with Mr. McGee, which are both from Chronicle. Camping Spree, for some reason, is only available in hardcover, but Down to the Sea is available in hardcover and paperback. And his art is so awesome. It is so sort of 1950s, just wacky and wonderful and so expressive. If you don't recognize his name and you're wondering where you've seen his art before, he does all the illustrations for Kate DeCamillo's Mercy Watson books, and the two of them together are just like cake and ice cream.
They're like toasted.
They're
toasted bread and butter.
They're like Oreos in my tummy.
They are.
Yes. So these are the stories of Mr. McGee and his little dog Dee, who are Mr. McGee is not. It seems uncharitable to call him not the smartest man in the world.
He's very simple. He has simple needs.
Yes. Yes.
He just likes to travel with his little dog.
He does. So they're gonna go down to the sea, and they're gonna have a nice boat ride, and they're having it. Except, as you can see from over here, right here in this corner, that there is a whale, and the whale is bored, and the whale has sort of decided that Mr. McGee and his little dog Dee are going to be his amusement for the day. So the whale comes and he gets the boat up on his blowhole and he starts to blow, and I'm sure that you can imagine what happens. They are up high in the air, and his art just evokes so much motion. I mean, I can just see the boat flying up into the air. We are kind of Chris Van Dusen fangirls, if you hadn't noticed, but justifiably so, because I mean, come on, look at this. Not only is the art amazing, and Mr. McGee and Dee are so haphazard and funny, but the great thing about these books is that, unlike a lot of rhyming picture books, Chris's rhymes scan perfectly.
No
so,
extra syllables.
Nothing.
No fake halting rhymes,
no,
forced rhymes.
No, I rhyme.
Everything is perfect.
Yes, so as a parent or a storyteller or a bookseller, to read them out loud is just joyous, because you're not in your head going, oh God, what? Oh, 12 syllables in this line, oh, 7 in the next. So we love the Mr. McGee books, and we love If I Built a Car, and this fall, coming from Candlewick.
From Candlewick, we are very pleased to show you The Circus Ship, which is actually not even a finished book yet, because, well, the book's not out yet, but it's coming next month, and we cannot wait!
It's so, so good. It's based on a true story about a ship full of circus animals that was traveling and sank off the coast of an island near Maine. And in the true story, apparently, the animals, mostly, they don't think they made it. But in the book, the animals all swim to a nearby island. So they have rescued themselves from the shipwreck, but they've also rescued themselves from the horribly mean, nasty guy who owns the circus. So they get onto the island, and I just love that sunrise.
Oh, so beautiful. The colors are awesome.
The townspeople, of course, are totally freaked out because, look, the elephant's walking outside his window, and they don't know what to do, and they're afraid, and they don't know if they should be. But, of course, eventually, the animals really make themselves useful. And they not only come to a sort of truce agreement, but they...
The tiger even rescues one of the children when there's a fire on the island.
So they live in, they have a very symbiotic relationship, and the townspeople get very used to the animals being there. Until one day, the mean guy, Mr. Payne,
circus ringmaster, shows up.
And he wants his animals back. And in what is absolutely the best part of the book, although it's hard to decide.
Maybe hard for you to see.
The animals are all hidden in the picture.
There's a camel hidden there in case you can't tell.
And so he can't see them because the townspeople have hid them, and you get to find them in the pictures. And so he has to leave because his boat is leaving. And the animals get to stay, and they live happily ever after with the townspeople. And it's so good.
We love his books.
Love his books.
We want to support him because we want to see more and more of his art out there, and we would like to see him, you know, be able to pay the rent and do all the things he needs to do, because artists like him deserve that.
Yes, and we'd also like him to come to our stores someday.
We would, someday.
But we understand that he
does
live in
England.
We
know that he likes Maine.
Yes.
He likes to live there.
That maybe Pennsylvania and Missouri are not as appealing as Maine, but... But that's okay. We hold out hope, and we've gotten to meet him, so we have actually gushed like this in person.
It's
probably
true.
This video is of no surprise to him. So the circus ship comes out in
October.
Sorry, we don't have a date for you. From Candlewick, the Mr. McGee books from Chronicle, If I Built a Car
from Penguin,
and the Mercy Watson books are also from Candlewick. So thanks for listening to our fangirl ramble, and we'll see you all soon. Bye!